This video has been brought to you by Learn Flutter Code, the platform that teaches you Flutter, and I'm great to you as a Flutter developer. So there are many reasons why people uninstall apps. So as Flutter developers, we are mostly responsible for technical issues or bugs. Having a bug-free app is something that you can control and achieve. So in order to achieve the dream of having a bug-free app is to do testing. A lot of them. And Flutter has recently released an update on the integration test. So in this video, I will share with you what is an integration test, not an immigration test, the pros and cons of an integration test, a demo on integration tests on an iOS app and a Flutter web project. And lastly, at the end of this video, I will tell you whether you should do an integration test on your Flutter app. So let's get started with what is an integration test. So there are three types of tests that Flutter supports. So the first one, or the simplest one, is unit test. And then the second one will be the widget test. And lastly, you got your integration test. So what are all of these test about? So the unit test verifies the behavior of a method or a class. You could say that we are checking the logical or the brain of the app. So the next test is the widget test. So the widget test basically verifies the behavior of the Flutter widget without the running of the app itself. So you will test probably a part or just a small widget of your app. The last test that we want to go through is the integration test. So what is an integration test? Well, an integration test is like a complete test. This means you test on an actual complete app or a large part of an app. So the objective of the integration test is to check whether all of your widgets are present and also your services are working as expected. Moreover, in your integration test, you can track the performance of your app. So an integration test runs on a real device or an operating system emulator, such as an iOS simulator or an Android emulator. Enough talk. Let me show you the actual demo. So inside the documentation for integration testing in the flutter.dev, you could see that we need to set up our project. So the new integration test package, we will have to put it right under our pubspec.yaml file or our development dependencies. Then the next thing is we're going to have a directory structure. So there are different folders that we need. We need an integration test for your integration test. Then you will have your test for your other unit test. And lastly, you will have the test driver. So what is this test driver over here? So this integration driver is a convenience wrapper around the integration driver plugin that enables you to run your new test inside the Flutter drive command. So this Flutter drive command over here will go through two files. So the first file that it will go through is the integration test over here. And the second file will be the widget integration test that you have created. I have with me here a simple counter increment smoke test. Basically, it will pump or render our counter app, and then we will verify that our counter starts at zero. Then once we tap on the button icon, then we will render the next frame and expect the counter to increment by one, which means we're going to find a text widget with the value one. So if you guys have created an integration test before, on the left, you will use the API of the Flutter driver. But now you are able to use the integration test package to do what the Flutter driver has done. So the new integration test looks very similar to a normal widget test, which is amazing. But the difference is we'll have this thing called the integration test widget Flutter binding ensure initialized. So this single line will actually run the integration test or opens up the app in your emulator or simulator or even a real device. And it will go through the different steps that you have created inside your widget test. So what is the command for you to run the integration test? So to run your integration test using Flutter driver, you will use this command. So if you were to look a little bit closer, there is this thing called a driver and there is this thing called target. So driver over here represents the integration driver that we have created right under the test underscore driver integration test driver dot dart file. So this is the driver that allows us to run the Flutter driver. For our target, this is where we want to run our different test, whether it is a counter test or even an authentication test on an actual device. So currently for this example over here, we are going to run the Flutter drive command, and then the target is where we are going to test our integration test. So I've created an integration test folder that reference to the widget integration test.dart file. So for our device, we already have an iOS simulator running, so we don't have to set the device. So if you were to press enter, so as you can see over here, the integration test is running the actual app. So it created the app and then runs it. And then once it finished running, then it will delete the app. So there's like a little bug that says it failed to stop the app, but it actually manages to stop the app successfully. Our test has passed successfully, and then we are okay to launch our counter app in the app store. So now how do we then run in a browser? So we are going to use this thing called Chrome driver. Then once you install Chrome driver, you will have to run Chrome driver using the port 4444. So let's copy this code and then paste it over here. Now Chrome driver has started successfully. The next thing is we're going to open up another terminal and then we are just going to copy this part of the code. So dash D, which is device, and then it will use the web server for our testing. So let's copy this. So now we just need to go to our previous command and then paste our dash D web server. Now let's press enter. And now it will run our integration test in our web server. All right, so for the integration test in our web server, it does not open the Chrome or whatever. It just says all tests pass. Anticlimactic, but it's okay. This test is better than having no test. So now we have gone through the integration testing. You might think, what is the pros and cons of integration testing? So let me explain the pros first. So the advantage of the pros of integration testing is you will have high confidence to push live to the App Store because an integration test has to go through an emulator or a simulator or even a real device to be tested. So the chances of it having bugs even though your test has passed is very, very small. So second thing is that so since you can test on an actual device or even an emulator or simulator, it is actually a scalable way for you to do your testing. So there is this service in Firebase called Firebase Test Lab, where they have actual devices that you can push to test your Flutter apps in actual devices. So if you want me to go through Firebase Test Lab, leave in the comments down below. And lastly, you will know how fast it loads and how fast it renders certain animations or even services. So now let's go through the cons. The first one is it takes a lot of time to set up the configuration. Moreover, since you're running an app in an integration test, you have to do more code. That means you have higher maintenance cost. So since you are running an actual app, then you will have to make sure that all of your updated widgets and such is according to the test as well. And lastly, it has a heavy dependence on dependency, meaning that for the integration test to run, you have to have the different packages such as your Flutter Material Library, Flutter Test Library, your main.dart library, and also the integration test package. So sometimes you have packages that's getting updated, then the maintenance costs will also pile up. With these pros and cons, you might be thinking, should I do an integration test? And the answer is always, it is a definitely depends. So what do you mean by it depends? If you are working in a startup, you'll probably have constant changes to your app because no app is perfect in the first iteration. So there will be a lot of breaking changes, and having integration tests will be a heavy investment on time, which startup depends on. So I will not recommend you to do integration tests. However, if you really want to, maybe a simple integration test on a simple feature would do. But I will only recommend if you have a mature app where there isn't a lot of UI changes or logic changes in the front end. So that means your company is already a few years in a row and there's not a lot of changes and there's a lot of users that's using your app. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you want more of this video, subscribe down below and comment down what other tests you want me to go through next. So that's it. Stay safe and all the best. Bye bye.